Welcome to the Sam Livecast. It's Monday, the 27th. We're back. We've been away. We had those 2 days off last week, Wednesday and Thursday, while Kelly and I took our youngest to college. And now we're empty nesters. And now the party should begin. Am I right?
Yes.
That's the plan.
Now is our time. Is that right? Three sons, 24 years plus. We've gotten up at night. We've gotten up in the morning. We've made the meals. We've fed the children. We've cleaned up after the children. We've done the clothes. We've made the beds. We've taken them to school, to Hebrew school, to soccer, to lacrosse, to baseball. We've taken back and forth and back and forth. We've sewn clothes. We've mended broken limbs.
And broken hearts.
Aw. It's 24/7. Am I right? And now it's our time. Am I right?
How long
now Kelly's got me not eating, not drinking, fucking exercising twice a day.
And
you know what I ate today?
We decide to quit drinking.
You know what I ate today? Here's what I had. I had an effing banana and peanut butter for breakfast. Yoo-hoo, party time. I wanted to run around naked. I was so excited.
And you could.
And for lunch,
home.
I had a little piece of salmon about this big that we had from last night and a little quinoa salad thing.
Yum.
And quinoa freaks me out. I don't get its look. I don't get it.
It's translucent.
It is, and that's what scares me about it. I don't understand it.
I
think it's going to come back to haunt people with medical conditions years from now.
Oh, that's scary.
Those people in the 2000s, they were all eating that quinoa, and now look at them all. They've got a second head growing off the back of their neck. And no alcohol.
And then what? Wait, what?
And mom's like, no, the alcohol on the weekends. I can't work like that. You can't take everything from me all at the same time.
Wait, what's the backstory to this?
The backstory is that I'm pudgy. That's the backstory, that I need to eat better.
That's okay, man. I'm a little pudgy, too.
I think you're looking good right now.
I have a new shirt on that I bought in Boulder.
Yeah, wow.
Oh, it's plaid. What is it?
It's plaid. Yeah, by the way, do you like it, Shannon?
I do.
Thank you. I get compliments on it from everybody. Mom hates plaid.
I don't hate plaid.
You do. You can't stand plaid, or you can't stand me in plaid.
No, it's just that every shirt you buy is plaid.
These days, because right now, I'm digging the plaid. And I'll tell you this. If you go to Boulder not owning a plaid shirt, they'll ask you to leave.
Oh, I can so see
it
you.
Is,
I can just see you walking around Boulder going, I need to get a plaid shirt.
No.
I need to get a new plaid shirt.
I wanted a shirt, and I went into a store and just happened to have a lot of plaid. And I like that. Got another one that'll break out. It's warmer, though. I got to wait for it to stop being 80 effing degrees in San Diego. What the hell's going on here?
Hey, it's cooled down. We went through this crazy heat wave, and now it's finally, like, at least cooled down a little bit.
Yesterday was nice because we cleaned the garage all day. Oh, yeah. By the way, here else is our fun. We come home from Boulder Friday night, Saturday, Sunday, both days, nonstop. We redid the garage.
Yeah, you guys are really letting loose.
Oh, God.
Yeah, but he just didn't tell
it's
you
a party.
That he did it naked.
Oh, yeah.
Because he could.
So funny. That's just so
Man,
funny.
This show's starting to sound like a show for retired people, dude.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
We're a so cooking show, man.
We take the child to school and get them all settled in. And I'm telling you see some kids there that look like they're ready for college. You see some kids there moving in, look like they're high school freshmen. They're just going to be a bear in the headlight. Bear in the headlight?
A bear in the Well, in Boulder, maybe.
In Boulder, right.
And that's only on my mind because that San Diego guy got eaten by a bear in...
What the?
What's that park,
Denali.
Shannon? Denali Park. Eaten Yikes. By a bear. He was photographing them for at least 8 minutes.
What?
The last photographs they found... Because the park rangers found his camera.
Oh.
The last photographs they found in the camera, the bear had turned and was coming towards them.
Oh, no.
What?
Hey, wait. That's like that bear guy. There was like a big bear documentary where this guy went and lived with the bears out in the wild for a very long time.
Them?
And then right at the end, towards the end, he just had a bad encounter with one of the ones that he had been
interacting because they're wild
with.
Animals.
Exactly.
It's terrible. Did you hear how they found him?
How they found
the
him?
The bear was sitting on his body.
The bear was sitting on his remains. Oh.
Just chilling there?
Yeah. Isn't that terrible?
Oh, God.
You know what just popped up on my phone?
What?
I don't have have my phone off. Why does it make noise if I got
the sound
off?
I know, didn't I? What did I yell before?
You yelled phones on silent, and I put the little button thing here down on the side.
Uh-huh. And yet it's an alarm or something.
The alarm, important. I guess. To check on the chef coats for the contestants in the Sam Livecast cooking competition.
Oh, heck yeah.
Which, by the way, the competition here will begin September 6th, and then it will be the 6th, the 12th, the 19th, and the 26th.
Hell yeah.
The preliminary rounds, two people at a time during the Livecast cooking behind me. And the four winners of that will go to the semis, and then the two will go into the finale at Fixtures Living.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have the dates for the semis or the preliminary or the final yet because we got to wait to see who it is, and then we'll definitely work around their schedule.
Mm-hmm. Everybody's real excited.
That water's real good. Real good.
You know what you can hide in water bottles, right? Just saying.
Oh, thank you. Now she's going to be coming around sniffing my bottle.
I'm not encouraging anything. No, I think it's good what you're doing. You're just going to be really hungry and really cranky.
I'm hungry right now, and I'm a little bit cranky and whatever. No, I have no choice about this.
But you won't be pudgy.
So what are we making tonight?
Yes. I had to think of something healthy.
And?
So it's still hot, so I wanted something that could be eaten while it was still hot. I wanted like an appetizer kind of thing because I knew if I made a big ass thing, I'd want to eat it. So we're making a roasted red pepper tapenade on grilled polenta. And by the way, do we grill polenta before? We talked about grilling.
We have grilled polenta. I'm going to say
yeah,
that.
I don't know.
Oh, I know what we did. We just put basil oil on.
Uh-huh.
Right. So here's the cool thing. So this is a 1 pound. It's a 24 ounce tube of pre-cooked polenta. Mm-hmm. It's already made.
And okay, there's got to be people out there that don't know what polenta is. So
it's basically cornmeal.
Uh-huh.
It's cornmeal that
Can you show us again? Sorry.
It's cornmeal that you mix with water and whatever. I don't know what the other junk that goes salt and whatever the butter whatever goes into it.
Yep.
You put it in a pan. You cook it. You take it out of the oven. You let it cool, and then you've got this flat surface that you cut into squares or triangles or whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Or you just buy this and it's already done. So it comes in the tube. I think they also call the shape a chub. A chub of polenta.
I think it is a chub of polenta.
Which, by the way, it's kosher.
You're a chub of polenta.
I am a chub of polenta. But here's what's interesting. In my quest to eat better, no fat, there are 6 servings in this. So about a sixth of it has only 70 calories.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
So cornmeal is
no saturated fat, no trans fats, no cholesterol, a little bit of sodium, little carbs, and that's it. Some sugars.
Wait, you didn't say what your snack was that I saw you eating when I came in the house.
What is it?
You know what I had? I basically had. Can I call this? I had a brown rice turkey roll up. I took a slice of turkey. And put a little mustard in it, a little grainy mustard, which is doesn't have a lot of sugars or fat or stuff like that, right? So a slice of turkey, little mustard in it, and then I made some brown rice today because brown rice makes me think that I'm eating healthy.
You can't even have white rice.
So I put the brown rice in it, and then I rolled it up like an enchilada, like a brown rice turkey enchilada. I don't know, but it was cold. It was good. Snack. It wasn't like a real fucking enchilada with cheese and cream and all that stuff in there, but it was good. I'm going to hit somebody in the head tomorrow afternoon. God. I can just feel myself moving down the...
Why don't you ask your fans if they have any cool, healthy recipes?
Yes, please. Cool. Please, thank you. You ask them.
Okay, so fans that are watching right now or in the future, go to facebook.com/SamTheCookingGuy and please
just post right now.
Help Sam out. Give him a healthy recipe. So he
because
go crazy.
Kelly can be like a food camel. She doesn't have to eat. And just know this. She comes home and she's starving sometimes. And she'll go, what will she do? She'll go for an apple or a pear. Oh, my God. Have some salad. Ooh, this salad is so good.
Maybe you should start eating more fruit.
I told you, if you would just eat.
It doesn't do it. It doesn't do it. If I would just what?
Eat what she
just
eats.
Just eat what I eat in a given day and let's see what happens.
I'd be like 3 pounds emaciated and starving, and I would probably murder you in your sleep and then eat you. I can't eat like you, honey. I love you. I can't eat like you. We go for breakfast. What do I want? I want poached eggs, something.
I want eggs Benedict,
right? I don't really do the pancake thing. Mm.
No, you don't do the French toast.
I don't do that kind of stuff. Waffles, I don't do. But I want eggs. So I like carnitas hash would make me happy. Brisket hash, corned beef hash, kind of, say egg, yolk, whatever, that kind of business, and some kind of toasty thing to dunk into it. What does Kelly have? Mm-hmm. What do you have when we go for breakfast? She's like a turkey sandwich.
No, I don't.
I have a clubhouse sandwich. You have a clubhouse sandwich.
A BLT. Or a fruit salad. Or a granola with fruit.
We went for lunch. We went for breakfast. No, lunch. Saturday. We went to D-Bar, whose owner, Keegan Gerhardt, famous for his time on Food Network Challenge. He's the head guy of it. You'd recognize him if you saw him. Maybe boys can find a picture.
Pulling one out
and
right now.
He will be here. There he is. You recognize that face.
Mm-hmm.
And Gerhard is a very,
looks like you.
Very German sounding name. I'm guessing
he's German. Yeah.
I'm guessing he's German somewhere there. But his glasses.
Gerhard.
His glasses are very European. So, you know, the Europeans like those kind of glasses. Anyway, we ate there. Well, I had roast beef. It was lunch. Roast beef on ciabatta roll, spicy horseradish. Mm-hmm. Like a spicy horseradish mayo thing was great.
That was good.
Kelly, what'd you have?
I had a...
Avocado salad. I'll have an avocado salad, please.
Didn't I have something else, though? Oh, no, I had that. Okay, and I had half your roast beef sandwich, and guess what else came for the table?
Sam's just us.
Famous for ordering for the table.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, some big bowl of poutine fries.
No, they were fries with
bacon,
Lynn, you know what I'm talking about? Bacon,
rice.
Yeah. Cheese, ranch.
That's at D-Bar?
Green onion. Yeah, they were really good. They were so good.
Wow.
Nice big bowl of them. I was just curious.
Can we make poutine again on the show?
Yes, of course we can make poutine.
Maybe we should do a different variation of poutine because, hey, what did I say? I sent you a picture from LA this weekend of poutine food truck.
I'll do the poutines that I did on the Today Show. I did a breakfast poutine, which I can't eat.
Please.
I'm not making
poutine that.
Until...
We're doing that. When are we doing that?
No, I don't know. No, I can't. I will not make that
on,
until I can
on,
eat
please.
It. I'm not making that until I can eat it.
I want it.
You've got some recipes here, Sam.
What are people suggesting? And by the way, if they involve fucking carrots
or like
celery
one.
Sticks, don't even read them.
Here's a good one. A chicken burrito bowl. Shredded chicken, salsa, black beans, some corn. Mix up and serve over brown rice.
I already have the brown rice in the fridge.
Very low calorie, high in protein, and fast and yummy.
That sounds good. And
I
the chicken.
I could do that.
You do all
That's
the time.
Very nice, yeah.
I could do that. I would probably do my own chicken for that, too.
Really?
Just buy a breast, flatten it out, grill it.
I feel a new week coming on. Healthy week.
To help Sam cope with his new health
craze
week.
Well, I believe
the fatty deal.
And Keegan, what's Keegan going to do Wednesday night? Dessert.
Dessert.
Because that's his thing. He's a famous pastry
chef. Well, at least we're going to get our dessert fix from somebody.
I can't guarantee anything, but do you want me to ask him to make like his healthy dessert? It's pretty good.
I want to handicap
We're not
the
all
going to
punish.
No.
What would that be?
He puts it on his menu.
Strawberries in a bowl.
No,
I don't want that.
He doesn't advertise as healthy, and it's really delicious.
No, I don't want him making anything healthy. I want as bad as he can make it here.
Yes.
I'll have one bite, even. That's all.
Yeah.
If Kelly lets me. But we'll have to eat quickly because I have to go to the exercise place after. Are we really going there tonight?
Yeah.
What are we gonna? People are gonna laugh at
the
me.
Gym. Is that? Do you mean the gym by exercise place?
Yes.
Where are you going? Are you one of the?
The
probably shouldn't say.
Yeah.
Pack.
It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
So if anybody wants to go see them, now you know
yes,
where to
please.
Go.
Come see me, and I don't have hair on my legs. There you go. Now we can know. I'll just get it out in the open right now.
No.
So in case you see me in person and I'm wearing exercise shorts or some kind of short pant thing, they would only be shorts. I don't wear culottes.
But you wear white flip-flops like you have on tonight.
And why is that a problem?
Not to the gym, he doesn't. Whoa, those are intense.
No, he might.
I like him, man.
Thank you.
Don't like Lynn.
Don't listen to Kelly.
Wait, hold on. What you neglected to say about your legs is that you may not have hair.
I don't have hair.
But your calves are jacked.
Spectacular.
They are jacked.
My calves are spectacular.
We've been telling him this for years. It's like he's got like Lance Armstrong calves.
I've never had.
Oh, maybe
that's
a controversial subject right now.
I've never. Yes, and I don't steroid myself.
You know what? I heard somebody on the radio say that this whole thing, this whole Lance Armstrong witch hunt for steroids, is he's been tested over 500 times. It's all because the French hate Americans winning their shit.
That's a conspiracy theory. But, you know, there's probably some validity to everything.
Obviously, yeah.
Where there's a little smoke, there has to be a little fire. It doesn't matter. Anyway, I don't have hair in my legs, so don't laugh. Just know I'm telling you. I'm completely fine with it, and I don't shave my legs. We were sitting there in Boulder, and it was like 90. And all the other dads are sitting around in their shorts, and I'm like this, hair, no. I don't know, it honestly looks like I've done something, and I haven't.
You have to show us your legs now, Sam.
You want to see my legs?
Oh, jeez.
I'm still laughing about the exercise
Oh, my God. Okay.
Yeah.
Are they more...
They're shiny.
Okay, wow. I got to get rid of the white flip-flop. The white flip-flop made it look like an absolute woman's leg.
That is so
We should take a screenshot and be like, man or woman.
It seriously looks like you just got back from the salon and they waxed your legs.
There's no hair. They're smooth.
They're more smooth than they used to be.
I didn't do anything, Shannon.
That is freaky. I've got to take that off.
Jeez.
Wow.
It's all right. Dude, I have no hair on my arms. They're completely smooth, man.
Okay, no offense. You're Asian. You're not supposed to. I'm Caucasian. I am supposed to.
Hey, all I can say is I'm glad that we don't have a hairy gene.
And I have a little I'd rather be
not hairy than hairy.
You're right. There's virtually nothing here, and here there's nothing.
Oh, jeez.
Maybe you have
I got a little bit here. There you go, Shannon. A little bit of hair in my chest. That's it, but it ends here. That circle is all of the hair.
Welcome to my family.
You get the Asian glow. You have no hair. Maybe you have Asian.
Lynn.
No, we're like the same person, man.
And my son, you're only a foot taller. And my son had Kawasaki's disease. He did.
He did. A very rare heart disease.
Hey, want to see the Sam livecast in person yourself? Yeah. Would you like to come and watch us shoot this?
Yes.
Well, here's your opportunity because you can. You can do this next week. Is next week? Is September 5th next week?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, it is. It's Tuesday.
No, it can't be Tuesday. Don't do that. Why would you do that to me now?
I think it's Tuesday. Oh, wait, no.
September 5th, next Wednesday, we will be live at Fixtures Living. Live at Fixtures Living.
We will.
At 6 o'clock. And what do you have to do to come? It's simple. You just have to RSVP to events@fixturesliving.com. Tell us you're coming. They just want to know. They want to have a little extra food there, a little cocktail or beer, whatever it is ready for you when you come there.
Oh, and they treat our people right.
They do. They are raising money and or stuff for Stand Up for Kids Oceanside. Takes care of homeless and street kids up in Oceanside. Stand Up for Kids organization is a really good one. So that's actually a different fundraiser.
Oh.
Oh, which one are you saying?
That's the... So this one is the Stand Up for Kids one. Stand Up for Kids Oceanside. So if you go to the Facebook where I posted tonight, there's a link to the Stand Up for Kids Oceanside wish list. So here's what you do. Go to email events@fixturesliving.com. Tell them you want to go, how many you'll be. Then go to the wish list at Stand Up for Kids Oceanside. Pick something or a couple somethings off the list. And send it and bring it with you that night. Don't come with one candy bar. You know, if you need to see first aid stuff, bring a box of candy bars.
Yeah.
Or a pack of water, lots of gum, or some buttons.
Two large Band-Aids.
Sewing kits, right. Boxers, all kids. We know kids go through, boy kids go through a lot of boxers. So find some stuff on the list, bring it with you that night. But we will be there. We will be shooting. We will be having fun. It will be live. You'll be able to see us in person. You'll be able to see the hair that I don't have. Lynn and I will show our legs that night. And you could wait, dude, you didn't tell me. Do you have hair on your legs?
No, I have hair on my legs, just not on my arms. So if we take a picture with my arms and your legs,
it'll be fine. Yeah, it'll be fine. Except you forget, I have that giant calf, so
yeah,
it might make your arm look really small. Anyway, next Wednesday at Fixtures Living here in San Diego. It's right off of Miramar Road. It's easy to get to. And we'll start our usual time at 6 o'clock. I think you can come anytime from 5 o'clock on. Come hang out, have something to drink, have something to eat, hang out, bring something for Standard for Kids Oceanside. It'll be a great time. Lynn and I will stand beside each other, and you can see how tall he really is. Almost had too much of this water now.
Guzzle.
I won't.
Chug, chug, chug.
We talked about Top Chef and all the millions of shows and the crews that they're having. I know where this went, where this started. Two things. One, remember we talked about Top Chef and it beating the hell out of the franchise? Mm. Well, it's not over yet. Because now there's a show called Life After Top Chef.
No way.
What? If you've ever wanted to know what some of them are doing, now, they're Fabio. What is Fabio doing with his career since he's no longer on the Top Chef? I actually enjoyed watching him. I don't watch the show anymore. Spike Mendelsohn, I know, is it Spike Mendelsohn? What's his name?
Can Spike balance his career goals with his family?
No, different Spike. Richard Blaze is all over the place.
Trailblazer.
Uh-huh. I mean, please. I think it's gotten to be too much.
I mean, they got
800
time
spinoffs is enough, isn't it?
It is.
I'm sure they're making money.
Whatever.
Top Chef's huge, man.
I know it is. I bought something that I can't.
Uh-oh. I have to interrupt.
What?
Laura Avery says on the Fixtures site, it says the live cast is on Thursday, September 6th.
Oh, Sam.
Shut up.
That's a bit of an issue. Sam.
Let me check my calendar, see what you told me.
Let me call Maria.
I'm such a killjoy, aren't I?
Are you serious, Kel?
We're calling her on air?
I have it on my calendar as the 5th, man, so I think you're right.
I do, too, but I just got to... I mean, if the Fixtures people have it there, hold on.
We'll show up on the 5th, and they'll be like, what the...
Let's just call Maria. So Maria
is
in charge of everything.
This livecast
is
brought to you by...
By Fixtures Living. And Maria's... Who's about to be here? Hold on.
This is kind of creepy.
Think she's gonna answer?
Hope so.
Here, you can hold your phone next to the love.
Oh, it's voicemail.
Ugh.
Oh.
This is terrible live television, Sam.
I hate it when this happens.
Yep.
Kelly, can you get on to her, please?
I am, actually.
Uh-oh. Hi there. How are you?
Sandy and you.
Guess what? You're live on the live cast right now. That's okay. You sound great. So we have a question. We have a question for you.
Okay.
We've been talking about coming there next week. The Stand Up for Kids Oceanside, having lots of fun. Everything's great, right?
Yep.
So I tell people what they need to do. They need to go email events at Fixtures Living, blah, 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 all that.
Yeah.
We believe it's Wednesday night. Is that correct? Motherfucker. God damn it. I've had a lot of problem with this. Shit.
You have had a problem with this. You've had a problem with this since we first started talking about it.
Piece of crap. So it's Thursday?
Thursday.
Gosh.
I'm moving it on my calendar right now.
All right. Well, I'm making it too. Okay. It's Thursday, ladies and gentlemen. Maria. Maria, what's your title?
Director of Marketing.
Director of Marketing. So she should know when it is, because this is definitely a marketing thing. It's Thursday, September 6th. Okay, so that means that the cooking competition prelims are the 5th, the 12th, the 19th, and the 26th. I've screwed up everything. I need a personal assistant.
Yeah, you're the worst.
I got trouble right here in River City. Maria, thank you. I wish I could show your picture. Can I show your picture? How do I make your picture bigger here?
Let's, can we get back to the show?
I won't do it. All right. Thank you. See ya. Ay vey. You know what it is? It's fucking lack of food is what it is.
Don't blame
my
it on
body
that,
is eating the brain cells to try and feed itself.
Dude. You do need a personal assistant, man.
I had one once.
Didn't work out.
Nope. That worked out for a little bit, and it didn't work out. And guess what? Kelly picked that personal assistant. Do we want to go into that history, sweetheart?
No, I don't.
Yeah, yeah. Kelly's choosing what I eat and my personal assistant.
Oh, so what?
Yep.
Someone on Facebook mentioned that we do kale chips for recipe, and we were supposed to do that.
Ooh, I love kale chips.
Remember?
Yeah, you bake them?
Yeah, something like that.
Kimberly Ames, thank you for the suggestion.
Could she just tell us what's... So, Kelly, are people saying... Yeah, thank you, Chris. Bacon. That's not in my... Frito scoops and cream cheese? What the hell?
Your first response...
Do you want to go through them?
LOL.
No. I just want to know how you bake... I think you drizzle with olive oil.
For kale chips?
Salt them.
Yeah.
The leaves, and then you bake them.
Yeah.
Just somebody tell me how long. That can't be bad for you. I should be able to eat a million of those, right?
Well, it'd probably be bad for you if you ate a million of them.
Look, someone comes to your defense... Domenica, the taunting isn't nice.
No, it isn't.
People are taunting, you know.
But how healthy, like raw organic, like those are, right? They people are taunting me, and I don't like that.
Portobello mushroom burgers. I love that suggestion. That came from the same person.
But I've made them. I can't have the bun.
Well, what about a wheat bun? Those are pretty healthy.
I don't know.
Is the my rule nephew Mark says
my nephew Mark says as long as I consume any carbs I'm going to consume by noon I should be okay. Cuz you do need some carbs. It's not like you can't go carbs at all.
No, you can, but that's isn't that Atkins? Isn't that what Atkins is?
Yeah,
and lose all the carbs.
And he died.
Yeah, he died exactly.
Oh, I'm not laughing at his death. I'm just saying that's he died. Most people will die in their lifetime.
Yeah. Well, I know, but he wasn't the one that... Right, that's true. That's true. Okay, I'm with you. Okay, well, I could cook something. I have to cook.
I'm hungry.
Would anybody like to do that?
Did you do the whole calorie counting thing?
By the way, did I do the who?
The whole calorie counting thing with your recipe tonight?
No, I mean, I just basically looked. I figured like the red peppers are probably not bad. This is not bad. I'm not going to have very much. I'm starving right now. Honestly, I'm starving.
Too, man. I'm pretty hungry.
I'm going to have to eat a few of these and then go exercise. Then I'll probably throw up. So
I can't believe
it's going to be great. It's going to be a great night. Everybody at home tonight. The only saving grace for me is that I'll be able to watch last night's episode of Breaking Bad, which I haven't seen yet.
See, there's always the upside to things.
How is that an upside when it comes to the food? That's my own personal.
But you're
gonna
be watching it without enjoying a nice cocktail? Wow.
No, I might have a cocktail.
When does that happen?
I think I can have one cocktail after I've done the gym and after I've starved myself.
Just without all your sweet shit in it.
Well, that's actually kind of what I thought we were going to do.
When were you gonna tell me? You're gonna wait till I shot somebody first? God. All right. By the way, October 19th, I just put a new class on my website.
Nice.
It's at Fixtures.
Nice.
And I hope my food situation is fixed by then. I basically have 2 months because the class is called Bacon is Our Friend.
Yeah.
There's, look at the stuff in there. Bacon cocktails, bacon fried rice. I'd eat the hell out of that right now. Bacon wrapped scallops, the butternut squash and crispy bacon salad. I had Kelly up to everything except the crispy bacon. No, you like bacon in a salad. That's a really good, and I put maple syrup in that dressing.
Whoa.
Super delicious. Nice. Gnocchi with bacon and peas. We did that here one night. Mm-hmm. So good. The mac and blue cheese. By the way, that mac and blue cheese. Wait, and then the something bacon for dessert. So you can take it off that. That mac and blue cheese is super rich.
Yeah, it is.
Super delicious. One of my favorite things ever. I say it's like my Achilles heel. Is that? No, my kryptonite. Because if I eat too much, it'll kill me. Honestly, and problem is you make a big thing of it, and then you got it in the fridge, and it microwaves beautifully. So I'm always taking some out, quick microwave eating it. The other day at lunch, Kelly said to me, by the way, I really love your mac and blue cheese. Will you make it sometime? And I don't know if she was just thinking diet. Shannon, look at Jordan right now. Look at quick. Oh, he was sound asleep on the couch. He worked hard yesterday. All right. Okay, I'm ready to cook something. I won't wear my white flip-flops because I don't want my women leg foot thing to
your
be too
lady
obvious.
Legs.
My lady legs. All right, I'm ready.
Let's do it.
See you.
Please hold.
Wait,
there you go. You're live, dude. Did you pop it on mute?
Pardon the technical difficulties.
Is the pack off? Yeah, I think the pack is off. Oh, no, I just heard you. Oh.
Can we check my batteries before each show? That would be so good.
No, there you can. Can you hear me now?
We can hear you now.
Okay, thank you. Are these rechargeable?
No. Oh, those ones, yeah. Oh, no, they were.
Yes or no?
I can't see everything from back here.
All right.
I think they were.
I'll go get them. Those are probably mine.
Okay. All right. I get getting yelled at by Jordan for throwing batteries out. By the way, look what I did. I brought my old cutting board out.
Nice.
Ironwood. What is this? Like 3 inches by whatever? This thing?
That used to be like your signature.
Everybody quiet.
Whoa.
That is a heavy, really heavy piece of wood. I love it. And I found it again in the garage. So the polenta has a little water in it. So I'm not going to cut this over the thing. Okay, this one doesn't.
Wait, you said it has liquid?
Oh, look at that. That was bad.
Oh, did you just
lose something? It has a little bit of liquid in it. Sometimes. I don't know why this one didn't. So here's what I want to do. I want to slice it and oil it, and then I'll be fine. You know what I'm saying there, Spanky? So we're going to do pieces about this big. I don't want to make them too big. I don't want giant mouthfuls of polenta. But I want to make it like a nice little repository for this roasted red pepper thing, little topping on that we're going to do. Mm-hmm.
Those look perfect.
Your mom's perfect.
Jeez.
Hey, Kel, I said something nice about you.
Actually, I didn't know whether you were talking about Lynn.
I looked up to see if we were talking about Lynn's mom or Max's mom.
Okay, so I'm heating the grill, right?
Mm-hmm. Are you really?
Yeah, okay. The little grill pan.
I don't see the pan on there.
Oh, you don't?
On the left side?
The black.
The middle thing. One.
Yeah. Okay. So watch. I need to oil these a little bit. So here's what I'm going to do. I'll just do them on here. Then I'm just going to throw them right onto the grill.
So just oil and then they're going right on?
And then they're going right on. We're going to let all the flavor come from the what we're going to put on them next.
Oh.
So that's getting hot. It's surprising how long these take. They take a few minutes to do. I mean, you know, maybe 10. But I've got to make the little tapenade thing, so I'm going to be okay.
Oh, cool. Okay, so we're putting those on and then doing the tapenade.
Right. So just oil, salt, pepper, all that kind of stuff is going to come in the tapenade, so we'll be fine, right?
Did we ever talk about how you came across this chub of polenta? Like, when did you first discover it?
No. Where?
I'm kind of curious, actually. Do you have a story?
No, not really. I mean, I remember seeing it in the store for the longest time.
I mean, just to be honest, I would never think about buying a chub of polenta.
I love the fact that you're saying chub.
That's what it's called, right?
That's what I call it.
Oh, I thought that was like the name.
Well, no, I think...
The chub of chorizo is the same thing, right?
Yeah, I think that's what this shape container is called.
Got it.
I think you're right.
Can somebody out there in Facebook world tell us?
Somebody will tell us. Wow, look at. Did I make the right perfect amount or what?
Uh-oh, Lynn. Be careful Googling chub.
I know, yeah. I have safe shirts on, so we'll be okay.
Okay, that's pretty funny. Okay, so I've got the oil here for this. Let me just clean off my board a little bit because, you know, I like to work clean.
Yeah, you do. To our detriment.
Well, no. Just to the slowdown of the show a
I
little
know,
bit,
I
but
know,
not
I'm
much more.
No, people don't care though.
People are okay.
All right, so for sure next Thursday, right? I just want to clarify for our
for sure next Thursday. Yes.
Audience that's going to come
I
out
really
and watch us live.
I cannot believe how long I've been messing up that date. And I know Marie and I have talked about this forever. Our roasted red peppers.
You tend to do that sometimes with dates.
I know. So, oh.
What?
I don't think I have any. Will you see if I have any Kalamata olives? I can look. So here's what I want to do. I want to just drain a little bit of this.
I think they're actually in that fridge.
The olives? So this is pretty easy. This all just goes in the processor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the red peppers here. Nice, like this. And while this is draining, see if Kelly can find me that. I have capers. Uh-oh. Oh, she found him. Pits, no pits. Pitted, nice. Who likes capers?
Me.
Love capers. Capers are really delicious. Let's just check and see how these guys are doing in here.
They sound like they're crackling.
Yep, they're crackling fine. Nope. Not even close. They're doing fine. So we're going to do this. But I think I'll use this. So the red peppers go in. I mean, you don't have to make a ton, but you want some in here. I want some capers, and capers are the, I think it's the flowering bud of a plant. Is that right?
Yes, I believe so.
Of the Cyperina spicerifaunus plant, something like that. It's true. Look how easy this is. Mm-hmm.
How good are those?
Mm-hmm. But you know what? You have to make sure that they don't have a pit. Because every so often in these pitted ones, there's a pit. And it will jack up your processor in the worst way. Garlic. One big fat clove of garlic here. This. I'm going to put a little, these roasted red peppers don't have any spice to them, so I'm going to add a little red pepper flake. This.
It seems like the polenta would be a great base for, you know, almost any kind of topping you'd want to put
exactly
on it.
That's exactly right. Yeah, you can do anything.
I never thought about doing that for some reason.
Yeah, that's great. Okay. Nobody move. I gotta just remember what I'm doing here. A little salt.
I'm just gonna make polenta and bacon.
Mm. You know what? They go together really nicely.
Do they?
Yeah.
Ooh.
And we're gonna use a good olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. We happen to have my favorite, Cortina from We Olive. And because I want flavor, and we've talked about this before, olive oil used like for sauteing mushrooms or, you know, like what we did here, I don't use it for flavor. I'm using it more as a lubricant. But I want the olive oil to be part of the flavor of this whole thing. So I'm using a good one. I'm using this Cortina from We Olive. We Olive has been a sponsor for a little while now. They're kind of a one-stop shopping for amazing California certified extra virgin olive oils. They've got 10 locations, but we like them because you can go online, you can click on shop now, you can buy olive oil online, and if you put in the promo code SAM, S-A-M, they'll give you 10% off anything you buy. They'll send it to you for $9.95, no matter how much you buy. And just hold on while I ask my wife, while she's laughing in the middle of me talking about one of our sponsors, this'll be good. What's going on?
Did you hear it, Max?
No, what?
Oh, my stomach and throat.
Oh, something about lubricant. Oh, no. Oh, God.
It just made the weirdest sound for about 10 seconds.
Oh, okay.
Okay, see, come here for a sec, Shan. I want you to see what these guys look like.
Just do it real quick. WeOlive.com, promo code SAM.
Thank you. See the stripes? Oh, that was really hot.
They look perfect.
I'm just going to
They're going to get a little crispy, huh?
Yeah, that's what you want. Yeah? But I'm just going to turn them a little bit to try and add just a little bit extra.
Did you hear the Canadian in me?
No, what'd you say?
It's getting crispy, yeah?
They are getting crispy, yeah?
Oi, it's getting crispy, yeah? Canadians ask everything in a question at the end. It's pretty good, eh?
It's nice to just turn them because they get stripes going in two directions, which not is less about looks and more about adding another layer of the crispy lines in here. That is what you want. But try not to rip them.
Like oh no, I have some bad news for you.
What?
What?
FYI, no more Coratina at We Olive until the next harvest.
What?
Terry Bannister tried to get some yesterday. Maybe we can find you the secret batch.
Oh, I was going to say, really? We must have a hookup.
Okay, let's just give this a little whiz. Ready?
Oh, man, Blake.
What?
Nice.
Because we're bringing back the Sam laws. Capers are the bud of the Caiparina cisphosphonensis plant. He was pretty close. Caparis spinosa.
I was that far away.
Caiparina is the drink we made.
Okay, but I got close, no?
You did.
Thank you. I have a lot of knowledge in my head.
And your stomach is eating your...
It's my
eating itself,
my brain.
So you can't really... your brain doesn't have the proper nutrients. Oh, we're getting a little smoky in the living room. Look at Jordan just passed out.
Oh my God, this is so good.
He really thinks that my dad is entertaining, as you can see.
Right.
Okay, but I have one problem. I didn't make enough.
Uh-oh.
Now I got to make a little bit more. I'm going to do this right now.
You're probably okay.
While I flip these guys over, just get this other side, right? So here's what you want. Some of them, depending on where they are in this little grill, are going to have more color. So these things are going to be freaking amazing. And I'm going to be able to eat one. Can I have one, Kelly?
Absolutely. That's what we're having.
This is our dinner?
Sure.
I'm so excited.
That's
oh,
wonderful.
See, that's what they all should have looked like that. That's because this one's turned down too low. This is not dinner, Kel.
Okay, we've got someone reporting in from the heart of Hurricane Isaac.
Really?
Mike Lockhart says, as we are about to get hit by a hurricane, you should be doing a show on how to cook span and sardines on a barbecue grill for your New Orleans fans.
Really?
Yep.
I haven't heard what's going on down there, but I'm pretty certain it's not good.
Chris Varble, famous quotes by celebrities. I have a lot of knowledge in my head. Sam Zion.
What is it? Just why is it pick on me tonight? Why is it pick on Sam Nate? I didn't do anything. I just complained a little bit about not being able to eat ever again. Oh, shit.
What?
Oh, I'm okay.
Those ones in the back look pretty.
The ones in the back look amazing. I can't wait for those.
Sam, you could have been eating all day.
If I had a little... But I can't eat all day, Kel. Hey, Kel.
Yeah.
I feel like sorry for all that noise.
Careful, you're going to wake Jordan.
What is this?
Cilantro.
It is?
Yeah.
I really wanted it to be parsley. And it's not. And I'm going to use it anyways. What do you think of that? What have I got in here? I've got a little bit extra of both of these things.
You're a badass. Right?
Mm. Okay. Now we can do this. Turn this off, turn this off. Let that do its thing. Almost there. Thank you, We Olive. That's going to be delicious. Buy capers. They're really good. And all kinds of things. Have we done puttanesca?
Yes.
Pasta puttanesca, yes.
If you weren't here when we did it, go back and watch that episode. Also referred to as whore pasta.
I was going to say search under whore.
It's probably there. It's capers, olives, tomatoes, garlic. Really super delicious, fragrant thing that you make in about 5 minutes. And by the time you finish cooking it, which is not much longer, I mean, you let it simmer for a half an hour. It's like a group of Italian grandmothers have been cooking in your kitchen for days. It's so good.
Yum.
So parsley would make more sense here, but I'm gonna like this because it's what I've got.
And you always need a little green garnish on top. That's one of the Sam laws.
That's one of the Sam laws, absolutely. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Get this out of here, get this out of here.
make some room so Lynn can see. Let me pull these guys off.
Oh.
Gosh.
Blake's asking, whatever happened to Sarah Hess?
You know what? Somebody, of course I think he is. Jilly was asking me about her the other day.
I know.
She hates us now.
What'd you do to her, Max?
I didn't do anything. It was Blake.
It was Blake.
So you got some that are dark and some that are not so dark, and they're all going to be delicious. Ow, ow, ow. Shit. Shit, S. Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Can you believe that another hurricane is about to hit Louisiana and New Orleans on the 7th anniversary of Katrina?
Yeah, I'm really, really sorry to hear that, too.
Yeah, terrible.
I mean, I know they're sorrier than we are, but...
That smells delicious.
Yeah, well, hope you enjoy it. Your dinner and lunch tomorrow.
So, okay, and you know what? What could be a more lovely lunch? Make a nice big salad and have a few of those on it.
I know, but the thing is, it's kind of like, this is now, I feel like I'm having an appetizer here.
I would order a meal salad with grilled polenta.
It looks beautiful. Mom, yes, we understand that, but the thing is, for big men, big, buff, beautiful men like me, like me, Sam, and Lynn.
Wait, big, buff, beautiful, hairless men.
Yeah. We need sustenance. We need something that's going to fill us up. And unfortunately, although those are fantastic, it's not going to fill us up like a steak or a burger.
No, and I know you're pushing the salad, and it's a lovely idea. I'm just saying, I'm going to have trouble making through this if it's just salad.
Yeah.
That's what's going to be the problem. Okay, then just a little green. That's pretty. That's a nice little appetizer, actually.
Oh, yeah. Show up to a party with that.
Let me just emphasize again, a nice little appetizer as opposed to a meal. All right, what do you think?
Do we have time for a question?
Yep, of course.
All right, well, Darsha Cecil Smith, who I haven't seen posting before, says, does polenta have protein, and would you serve this as a vegetarian dish only, or what meat would you put with it?
Oh, wow, so many questions all at once. Hang on. Is there protein?
Yeah, let's see the protein.
There's 2 grams of protein in a serving, which I don't think is very much.
It's not a lot, but it's some.
But it's a little bit.
Yeah. Darsha, I'd put bacon on it, like I said earlier.
See, you know, I think... let me just have one bite.
Oh, I can hear the crisp. The crunch.
Mm-hmm. And by the way, this little tapenade you could make days ahead, and it would be delicious just sitting in the fridge, and the flavors would get better. So, when we've got grilled polenta outside, and we've made a salad, it's a really nice thing to serve with the salad, like instead of bread, because it's fun and it's crispy. And you can really enhance the flavor of it by doing all kinds of things. The first time we made it, we just brushed it with basil oil and then did it on the grill outside. I think you could probably, holy shit, that was good. I think you could probably broil it and get it crispy and beautiful and stuff, just like we did. It takes on the flavor, because it's really just cornmeal, it takes on the flavor of pretty much anything that you want to put with it. So if you're doing like a teriyaki chicken kind of thing, and you want a little something on the side with a little crunch to it, you could do thicker slices of this, you could do them like in finger shapes, anything you've got, you could do. And it's delicious. You could almost, look at it, it's like a little polenta taco. Quick, Shannon, my fingers are burning. Quick, Max, get on that. Oh, shit.
It's hot?
The stuff's
we got it. We saw it. I just want to go back to Facebook for one more second. Mm-hmm. Mike Street says, this is a time I wish I could pause live TV. I'm grilling cedar plank baby back ribs. I need to go check on them.
Oh.
Cedar plank baby back ribs, Mike?
Wow.
I like your style.
Mm-hmm.
I like your
style. Those sound good. Those sound really good. Mm-hmm. Okay. This has been good. We've done well tonight. We have Keegan Gerhardt here
on Wednesday to talk about his fame as a pastry chef, his celebrity as the guy on Food Network Challenge. He was on a ton of those. Want to know what everybody's like, what it's like, did he have fun with it? People are always crying on that show.
Yeah, they are.
Always crying.
It's a lot of stress, man.
There's a lot of stress, yeah. This is like you've got 8 hours and you've got to turn nothing that's made yet into like a Disneyland castle with your own favorite characters all popping up, and it's got to be good. Mm-hmm. And it can't break. So we'll talk to him. Thursday of this week is going to be my favorite sauces, my favorite jarred things. All these things that I keep in here that I find important that I use in my everyday cooking. Like the hoisin and the black bean that I like to use in the Asian stuff. All those things, we're going to talk about those, and we'll make a bunch of stuff out of that. It's a lot going on. Next week, we're at Fixtures on the Thursday, right?
The 6th, yes.
On the Thursday, the 6th.
Jeez.
And the cooking competition starts Wednesday of next week.
What?
Right here. That's crazy. I can't wait. Thanks for being here. Tell your friends. Go to We Olive, buy their stuff, go online, go to Fixtures Living, and remember, events at fixturesliving.com, RSVP for next Thursday, we'll be there, we'd like you to be there too. Thanks for hanging with us.